North Carolina vinyl picker, and I'm in picker's paradise. Yeah, I'm at the antique store. I'm do some filming.
Oh, they got a whole record.
There's my wife.
Oh, hi.
Yeah.
He's Artie's record hunting.
He is. North Carolina vinyl picker. And I'm looking for the deals here today. So stay with me and I will take you on a tour of this place. It is huge. Stay tuned, there'll be more. Good Monday morning. It's time for the North Carolina Vinyl Picker Show. And today's show is brought to you by Mr. Steve Carlson. Yes. Mr. Steve Carlson has got an excellent show. Yes, he does. It's the early morning Sunday show. And that's what today's show is brought to you by Mr. Steve Carlson. If you're not subbed up to him, I don't know what you're doing. Just go ahead and get off my channel right now. Go sub up Steve and come back. Or you could do it later. I'll have a link down below. And it'll also be a link down below to my store and Discogs for all you special people out there. Yes. We have the mail. We have J&B Vinyl from Lenore. And those were the day Antique Mall in Sugar Mountain. Also, I went to Harvest Records this past weekend and went there with my daughter. And I got a bunch of stuff. So I got more to show you. So here we go. At the end, I'm going to do a room tour. I'm going to show you that at the end. That way there, if you want to go ahead and see the room tour, you can. Or you can just watch the picker show all his stuff he picked up this week. Either way, I'm good with either one. I'm just glad you're all here and enjoy the show. And if you like the show, sub and subscribe. I get about 100 viewers every week. And nobody watches past 6 minutes on my video, so I try to keep it down to 6 minutes, and then people complain, I need more. Okay, so I'll do more, and then nobody watches. So what do you got to do? Got this in the mail. Phil Collins. Mr. Phil Collins. Yes, another day in paradise. That's why I'm just living here. Another day in paradise. Great single. I only had the sleeve before, so now I got the UK. Mr. John Anderson, who's on tour right now, I'd love to go see him. He's going to be in Georgia and Nashville. That's the closest he's going to be to me. So anybody out there wants to take the picker tour, just let me know. I'll drive. John Anderson. This is, what is this? Oh, Surrender. The B-side is Spider. And it's from the album Animation. It's his third album. Menage, it's a Canadian band, just got turned on to. This is one of my five bands that I'm getting into this year. So there you go. Here's number one, Menage. I told you I was going to let you know what the five bands were. Well, this is one of them, Menage. Canadian band. Check them out. You'll love them. Renaissance, love them. This is probably their best last album they did. The Jour d'Or, this is a promo. I put my copy, my old copy, in my store, Discogs. Did I mention that? Big Cheap Vinyl 57. It'll be a link down below. You can get there. UK, Danger Money. Picked this one up for like $3. And my original copy that I had with the red label. You know where that's at, right? Yeah, it's in the store. It's in the store. And then Thomas Dolby. One of the 80s artists that I really liked was Dolby. And this in here is Hot Sauce. She's hot and spicy and twice as nice. Oh, Lord, she fills me up. She calls it hot sauce. It's hot and pepper. Okay, that's enough of that. And I got two copies. Of course, you got to have two copies. One of them's going in the store. And this one here is mine. So, yeah. I had to get an extra copy because the postage wasn't enough. So then, that's all that stuff I got in the mail. Went to J&B Vinyl. Now, that's in Lenore, North Carolina. I had an old store. He had to get out of the store because the fire department was taking the property next door. They leveled the building. 6 months later, he's opening a new store. He also got bit by a brown recluse spider. He almost died. The guy's really nice. He does sell online, J&B Vinyl in Lenora, North Carolina. Him and his wife, Barbara. Excellent people. So, yeah, I showed you a picture of the building last week. I'll probably put another picture in there this week. I'm kind of week ahead. I've already got a whole nother bunch of records here I want to show, but I'm going to save them for next weekend because I went to Asheville. But I got Z-Bop there while I was there. Carlos Santana. I think he had a fiver on that. Another fiver on this one. This was Neil Diamond, Do It, and this is on Bang. I'm all in on the early Neil. I love Neil Diamond. I love his early stuff. Yeah. Julian Lennon. Surprised to see this there. This was, I paid up a little bit for this one. I paid $10 for this. But this is his third album. I did not have this one. Not as good as his first two, but it was good nonetheless. It suffers from that 80s sound. Some of this stuff does. Phil Collins, Hang In Long Enough, 12-inch single. Found that at J&B. Found Susudio, J&B. These were all $5 a piece. Then this was probably the pick of the day there at J&B with Linda Hoover. Backed by Steely Dan. This is a great album. If you don't know this album, give it a listen. This was a Record Store Day maybe 2 years ago. So enjoy that. You get that, stream it, listen to it. This was also there at J&B. This was a Steve Winwood 12-inch single of Split Decision. I did not have this one. I have just about all of them, but I didn't have that one. So that was nice to get. And then we went to, where we go to? Oh, we went to Those Were the Days. First, we went to Banner Elk. We had some lunch. Beautiful place up there, Banner Elk Cafe. If you're in that area, stop in for lunch. Never had a bad meal there. Those Were the Days. Antique Mall is right up the street. It's in Sugar Mountain. And the guy's real cool. And he's got a really nice record thing in the back. And the wife's walking around. And she says, I didn't even know this was back here. I'm like, yes. So she walked in on the video. Timbuk 3. Yes, future's so bright, I think I'll wear shades. And Peter Frampton. Yeah. This one here I did not have. Did not have either one of these. And I'm glad I got them. Found this one there. I was really shocked for a tenner. And yeah, Punch and Judy. Market Square Heroes on the back. Along with Three Bolts Down from the Candy. Pink Floyd, The Wall. Yeah, he had this on the wall. Had $45 on it, and I had some extra cash on me. So I decided to pick it up since I didn't have one. The copy I bought local had a Lip Warp on it. You got to check your records, folks. You got to check them every time you get them because I paid a tenner for that, and it's trash. So I don't know what I'm going to do with it. It's in a box. And, yeah, so I'll probably give this a listen. Not my favorite Pink Floyd album. Not my favorite. Not even on my top five, probably. But good album nonetheless. David Gilmour's guitar work's always great. I just listened to the A side of this. Of course, this is Peter Baumann. He was with Tangerine Dream through their most, probably the earlier part up to, I guess, up to the late 70s, he was with the band. And then he went solo. And this is his first solo album. And it was an import, and he had $10 on it. And I couldn't get it fast enough. It's on my list. It was nice to get something off my list. So there you go. That's all the stuff that I got this week. Glad to bring it to the table to show you. Thank you for all my new subscribers. I've been getting a lot of new subscribers and a lot of comments. I appreciate the comments. If there's anything on here that you want me to cover, leave a comment down below. I can do it. I got lots of records to show. I've got almost 400 videos. So are you a collector out there, or are you a listener? That's my question of the day to you people, you good people out there. Or are you both? Do you collect and listen, or do you just collect them? Some guys tell me that kids come in there nowadays and they buy vinyls. They call them vinyls. And they buy them just for the artwork, and they put them in a frame. They put them on the wall. They don't even play them. They don't even have a record player. They're just using it for the artwork. Isn't that crazy? Yeah? That's what they're doing. Record sales are up, folks. They're up. So stay tuned. At the end of this video, I'm going to show you a room tour that I did. Pretty cool. It's to the music of Peter Baumann. So hopefully I won't get flagged for it. And enjoy the rest of the show. And I'll be talking to you soon. North Carolina Vinyl Picker. Support them troops if you can. I'm out. Thank you.